गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीबॉडी. टुडे इन आवर क्लास वी विल स्टार्ट अ न्यू चैप्टर. द चैप्टर नेम इज इंडियन इंडिपेंडेंस. ओके, सो लेट्स स्टार्ट. फर्स्ट वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द इंट्रोडक्शंस पार्ट ऑफ दिस चैप्टर. यू नो द सोल्जर हु वेर एम्प्लॉयड बाय द ईस्ट इंडिया कंपनी. यू ऑलरेडी लर्न दिस रिगार्डिंग दिस चैप्टर इन योर प्रीवियस क्लास. द चैप्टर इज द फर्स्ट फ्रीडम स्ट्रगल, राइट. फ्रॉम दिस चैप्टर यू ऑलरेडी नो अबाउट द दिस टाइम ड्यूरिंग बिफोर इंडिपेंडेंस दैट ब्रिटिश ईस्ट इंडिया कंपनी रूल्ड हियर. ओके, सो दैट ब्रिटिश ईस्ट इंडिया कंपनी फाउट अगेंस्ट द ब्रिटिश रूल इन फर्स्ट वॉर ऑफ इंडिपेंडेंस. ओके, इन दैट टाइम द सोल्जर, ओके, दे अगेंस्ट फाउट अगेंस्ट द ब्रिटिश रूलर. देन दे डीड दिस टू द प्रोटेस्ट अगेंस्ट द ill treatment of Indians by the British, and this war was suppressed by the British government. Okay, and in this time you already know that there is a failure of the first war of independence. Okay, and did not bring down the spirit of the freedom among the people of India. And in this time there is so many leaders are here, like the leaders of the various walk of life started analyzing the reasons behind this failure of this first freedom struggle, freedom war. Okay, and here is in this time you can see there is so many social reformer are there, and here the important social reformers are like the Raja Ram Mohan Roy, Ishwarchandra Vidyasagar, and the spiritual leader like Swami Vivekananda started educating people about the social evils which is prevailing in India in that time. And according to them, the ignorance of the people had to treat it before they could fight against the British Raj. During this time we call that is the British Raj. Okay, then the effort of these leaders enhanced the spirit of the freedom in the Indian people or Indian masses. Then people realized that they have to unite and fight against the British. Okay, and this led to the foundations of the Indian National Congress. We will discuss after that what is Indian National Congress. Okay, and then the leader who fought for the freedom of our country believe in two philosophy. Okay, one group which is consist of the leaders like Gopal Krishna Gokhale, Dada Bhai Noraji, W.C. Banerjee, they believe in achieving freedom in a peaceful way, without any violence. These leaders were known as moderates. Okay, and another group, the group which is adopted the path of violence and threat to achieve the goal or achieve the freedom from the British. Okay, such leaders like you can say such leader like Lala Lajpat Rai, Bal Gangadhar Tilak, Bipin Chandra Pal, and V.O. Chidambaram Pillai, they are some people who are believe in the path of violence and threatening. They are called extremists. Okay, and here I told you three names like the Lala Lajpat Rai, Bal Gangadhar Tilak, and also Bipin Chandra Pal. These three names in that time called Lal Bal Pal. Okay, these three leaders are called Lal Bal Pal. Okay, you have to remember the name. Next, now we will discuss. I already told you the when the Indian National Congress formed. Now I will discuss one by one in the particular time during who and who is the form. Who is behind this form? Behind these organizations. Okay, first the Indian National Congress was started in the year 1885 by the Alan Octavian Hume. Okay, he was the founder of the Indian National Congress. And he was a British officer with the support of many Indian leaders. It was the first organization which is politically moved against the British. Then the first meeting of Indian National Congress was held in Mumbai. Okay, this is the very important question. Where the first meeting of Indian National Congress held? Okay, this is in Mumbai. Okay, and here, who is the president of this Indian National Congress? The president of the Indian National Congress of this meeting was W.C. Banerjee. And who was the general secretary of this meeting? Already you know the Alan Octavian Hume was the secretary of this meeting. Okay. The people of India provided an overwhelming support to this Congress party, which led to a strong foundations for this movement. And the Congress claimed that the British should employ Indian as a higher official in administration. You know, during before the independence, during the time of British Raj, British mostly hired the Indian people in the low rank, low official rank. But in this time, the Indian National Congress claimed they demand that they should hire the officer, the Indian people, as a higher official in administrations, okay, and bring about the political reform, okay. And here, next, you see, they put their demands in polite way due to influence of the moderates, they believe in the peaceful path. They did not do any violence, okay. These demands, British should hire the Indian people into the higher official in administration. But this demand were rejected by the British government. Okay, and the extremist group criticized the policy of the moderates and activated violently to impress their demand. Okay, and then that time Bal Gangadhar Tilak was the most important extremist leader. He deeply believed in the British education system that ignore and defame Indian culture, Indian value, Indian history. Okay, so in that time, he was the first Indian nationalist to demand Swaraj, okay, as the destiny of the nations. Okay, what is he give a slogan? What is his slogan? Is his slogan was Swaraj is my right and I shall have it. This is the slogan which is given by Bal Gangadhar Tilak, and it was a source of the inspirations for the many peoples of India, and become very popular through his newspaper. His newspaper name was Kesari. Okay, and the British, any state, both moderate and extremists, or often and threatened them cruelly in the prisons, and they also took them as a threatened this. After that, we will discuss about the partitions of Bengal. Partition of Bengal mean the nationalist movement in Bengal was very strong, and Bengal was then the largest province of British India, which include Bihar and the parts of Odisha. Okay, in 1905, Lord Curzon divided Bengal into the two territories, a Muslim majority territories, the name is the East Bengal, and the Hindu majority territories, the name is West Bengal. Okay, then the people and the national leaders realized that this was the divide and rule policy of the British government. You already learn about this divide and rule policy in our previous chapter, right? And in protest, the Swadeshi movement was started. What is the Swadeshi movement? In this movement, they decided to buy only Indian product and boycott all the foreign product. Okay, the British tried to suppress the movement, but they were unsuccessful, and as a result, they had to revoke the partitions of Bengal. Okay, Now we will discuss about the return of Gandhiji. You all of you know that Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi, who is popularly known as Gandhiji, was a barrister who went to South Africa, where he fought against the racial discriminations which is committed by the white rulers. And then Gandhiji returned to India in 1915 and become the undisputed leader of Indian people. And he played a leading role in Indian struggles for freedom. And Gandhiji are disciplined of and he very impressed by the Gopal Krishna Gokhale, who is adopted too rapid to fight against the British. They were number one, non-violence and Satyagraha. What is that non-violence and Satyagraha? I already told you, moderates that believe in peaceful way. They doesn't believe in violence way. So in that case, they are only there is a for the freedom. They the against the British, they only fight into the two way. One is the non-violence, and the other one is the Satyagraha. And due to his simplicity, commitment to causes, truthfulness, and which is attractive the Indian people, and who readily followed his philosophy. Okay. The next topic is Rowlatt Act. Rowlatt Act, the British executed another act that is called Rowlatt Act in 1919. Okay, and it was also known as Black Act. Black Act, and the act which is empowered the government to put people in jail without any trial. Okay, without any trial, any time they can put anyone into the jail. Okay, and Gandhiji called to a countrywide protest against this act. Okay, and on 13th of April in 1990, people gathered in a small park in Amritsar. That park is called Jallianwala Bug to protest against the this act, and in the arrest of the leaders Satyapal and Safiuddin Kechwal in that time. Okay, and the British General Dyer blocked the main entrance of the park and ordered his soldier to fire at the unarmed and the unsuspecting crowd or the people, where the people's present there in that park, in the small park, there is more than 5,000 people are there. Okay, but in that time about 1,000 people were killed and many were injured by this fire. Okay. This shattered the faith of the whole nations and provoked a great fight against the British. Okay, now another movement is was happened in that time, that is Khilafat movement. What is that? Turkey was defeated in the First World War, and the victorious power decided to divide Turkey among themselves and created a sense of discontent among the Indian Muslim. The Muslim leaders of India, two names you have to remember, one is Swaqat Ali, another one is Muhammad Ali, they are also called Ali brothers, okay, started the Khilafat movement in 1919 to protest against the British treatment of the Caliph or the Sultan, you can say, of Turkey. Sultan or the Caliph, they are the religious head of Turkey. Okay, and allusions was made between the Indian National Congress and the Khilafat leaders to work and fight together for the causes of Khilafat and Swaraj. Okay, and in that time, massive protest, strikes and act of the civil disobedience spread across in India. Okay, and Gandhiji and the Ali brothers and the others were imprisoned by this by the British in that time. Okay, so today is only we learned about this. I think all of you understood. If there is any queries, please comment below and subscribe my channel, like, comment, share. Thank you.